Crazy. That's how NATO officials are describing what's happening in Ukraine right now. Not because it's reckless, but because it's revolutionary. Across forests and farmlands in eastern Ukraine, a network of cheap microphones and cell phones is quietly rewriting the rules of warfare. It doesn't launch missiles, it doesn't jam signals, it just listens. And somehow, that's enough to terrify Russian drone operators and stun NATO generals. But this is more than just an acoustic trick. Ukraine's new system isn't just hearing the enemy, it's hunting them. And the story behind it, it starts in the unlikeliest place. An AI company that used to clone celebrity voices for Hollywood blockbusters. What they built next is now the most underestimated weapon on the modern battlefield. Let's break it down. ReSpeecher, founded as a voice synthesis startup, spent years perfecting machine learning algorithms that could analyze and recreate human speech patterns. Their technology was sophisticated enough to clone the voice of Star Wars characters and create convincing digital performances for major film productions. But when Russia invaded in 2022, the company's founders, led by CTO Dmytro Bielyevtsov, faced a choice that would define their contribution to Ukraine's defense. The pivot from entertainment to defense wasn't immediately obvious. Voice cloning and missile detection might seem worlds apart, but they share a crucial, common foundation. They both require sophisticated audio signal processing and pattern recognition through machine learning. The same algorithms that could distinguish between different human voices could potentially be trained to identify the unique acoustic signatures of incoming threats. Working with Pavlo Tsyupka from I3 Engineering and Marianne Solim from Ukraine's 125th Territorial Defense Brigade, the ReSpeecher team began developing what will become known as Zvuk, the Ukrainian word for sound. The challenge was to create a system that could reliably detect and identify Russian missiles and drones from the overwhelming background noise of everyday life. The machine learning models had to distinguish missile engines from an audio landscape that included wind, road noise, flies, and other insects, engineers' voices, cows mooing, chainsaws cutting wood, or anything else that makes sound in the Ukrainian countryside. The actual military equipment signatures that the system would be trained to detect represented just 0.1% of the source information. Initially, the system had a roughly 50% accuracy rate, essentially a coin flip. However, through iterative training and the gradual accumulation of real battlefield audio data, collected with help from military units actually experiencing attacks, the team began improving their algorithm's ability to separate threats from background noise. The hardware component of Zvuk was deceptively simple, yet ingeniously effective. Each station consisted of curved acoustic mirrors, approximately half a meter in diameter, designed to concentrate sound waves onto highly sensitive microphones. This works similarly to how satellite dishes focus radio signals. This acoustic collector was backed by a computer roughly the size of a shoebox, running the AI algorithms that processed incoming audio in real time. But the actual breakthrough came when the team solved what they called the domain shift problem. Sounds recorded from internet sources or at safe distances weren't adequate for training. A missile flying far overhead produces a completely different acoustic signature than one passing nearby. This meant that the developers needed to work within the Ukrainian military itself and in real-life environments. Units in combat zones would record close flyby data that allowed the AI to learn the actual sounds of incoming threats. This allowed Zvuk to achieve what its creators claimed was zero false negatives by 2022. As such, the system was never wrong in determining that a sound was actually being created by military equipment, though it occasionally triggered false alarms. The system's effectiveness was demonstrated within hours of deployment. It detected a cruise missile just 4 hours after setting up its first operational station, which was proof that its acoustic detection concept worked in real combat conditions. However, Zvuk's initial deployment was limited in scope. The network consists of approximately 40 stations scattered across Ukraine. This was sufficient for proof of concept, but far from providing comprehensive coverage. Additionally, detection ranges were a modest 3 miles for drones and artillery, and 5 miles for missiles, and the system would need further development to achieve the strategic impact Ukraine needed. As such, Zvuk established the foundational technology that would enable everything that followed. It proved that AI-powered acoustic detection could work reliably in combat, that miniaturized hardware could process complex audio signatures in real time, and that civilian technology companies could rapidly adapt their expertise to critical defense applications. But most importantly, Zvuk demonstrated the core principle that would drive the next two evolutionary stages. Acoustic detection could provide early warning for low-altitude threats that traditional radar struggled to track, and to do so at a fraction of the cost of conventional air defense systems. This resulted in the challenge becoming how to scale effective acoustic detection from dozens of stations to nationwide coverage. The solution emerged from what might seem like an unlikely source. two Ukrainian engineers working in a garage. But unlike the sophisticated AI startup behind Zvuk, this approach emphasized simplicity, cost-effectiveness, and rapid deployment over technical sophistication. As General James Hecker, commander of US Air Forces in Europe and Africa, described it, these engineers put a microphone and a cell phone on a 6-foot pole to listen for one-way UAVs. This created a paradigm shift in the entire design, proving that effective acoustic detection didn't really require cutting-edge hardware if the network could be large enough and the signal processing efficient enough. The project, dubbed Skyfortress, represented a fundamental shift in approach from Zvuk's high-tech station model to a distributed sensor network. Rather than deploying sophisticated acoustic mirrors and dedicated processing units, Skyfortress relied on much simpler hardware that could be manufactured quickly and deployed widely. What Skyfortress needed to do instead was coordinate thousands of simpler sensors into a coherent detection network, and it did. The mathematical principle underlying this approach is called acoustic triangulation. When three or more acoustic sensors detect the same sound, the tiny differences in arrival time at each point can be used to triangulate the exact location of the source. This is the same principle that enables GPS positioning, but it's applied to sound waves rather than radio signals. According to various military officials, Skyfortress ultimately deployed between 8,000 and 10,000 acoustic sensors across Ukraine, creating what General Hecker called very accurate information that is synthesized in a central computer and sent out to mobile fire teams. This massive sensor network provided several crucial advantages over the more limited Zvuk deployment. First, the sheer number of sensors created redundancy that improved overall system reliability. If some sensors were damaged or malfunctioned, the network could continue operating effectively. Second, the wider coverage meant that incoming threats could be detected earlier and tracked constantly as they crossed multiple sensor zones. But most importantly, this approach enabled a level of precision that individual sensors couldn't achieve. While a single acoustic sensor might only provide rough directional information, multiple sensors networked together could generate precise coordinates, flight paths, and speed estimates for detected targets. The cost-effectiveness of this approach proved revolutionary. According to NATO estimates, the entire Skyfortress network cost approximately $54 million to deploy and maintain. This is less than the price of two Patriot air defense missiles, which are practically expendable goods. Each sensor costs between $400 and $500, making the system scalable across the entire nation. The operational effectiveness was equally impressive. In one engagement in 2024, cited by Hecker, Ukraine successfully intercepted 80 out of 84 incoming Russian drones. This represents a 95% accuracy rate, achieved through the combination of acoustic detection and rapidly deployed mobile fire teams equipped with conventional anti-aircraft guns. But Skyfortress also revealed the limitations of ground-based acoustic detection. The network excelled at detecting low-altitude threats like drones and cruise missiles, but couldn't match the range and altitude coverage of traditional radar systems. Detection ranges remained in the single-digit miles, providing valuable but limited early warning time. More significantly, the fixed nature of the sensors meant that the network could only provide coverage where stations had been deployed. If Ukraine were forced to change the location of the front, such as by retreating or advancing, it would need to set up more operating stations. These limitations would drive the development of the third evolutionary stage, mobile acoustic detection, that could go anywhere reconnaissance operations were needed. And this is where the German manufacturer Quantum Systems comes in, improving on its vector drones. Unlike the ground-based sensors of previous systems, using drones essentially creates mobile acoustic sensing platforms that can provide detection coverage anywhere the drone can fly. The acoustic sensors that accomplish this are developed by Valor's Acoustics, now a wholly owned subsidiary of Quantum Systems, and are scheduled to be installed on the drones over the next few months. They are approximately the size of an index finger and weigh just a few grams, but can still identify artillery and mortar fire at ranges up to 10 miles. This development represents yet another leap in how acoustic detection fits into broader military operations. Where Zvuk and Skyfortress were primarily defensive systems designed to protect Ukrainian territory from incoming attacks, these reconnaissance drones are active intelligence-gathering platforms that can locate enemy artillery positions. So instead of waiting for enemy aircraft to approach Ukrainian airspace where ground-based sensors could detect them, the military can use them for search and destroy missions that don't rely on direct, visual contact for initial targeting. This capability addresses one of the most persistent challenges in modern warfare – rapid detection and first engagement rules. Traditional methods of locating enemy guns rely primarily on radar systems that can track incoming projectiles back to their point of origin, or on visual reconnaissance that requires direct observation of artillery positions. Acoustic detection offers several advantages over these conventional approaches. Unlike radar systems, which emit signals that can be detected and targeted by enemy forces, acoustic sensors are completely passive. They only listen, never transmit. This makes it much harder for enemy forces to locate and defeat through electronic warfare or direct attack. Additionally, as sound is deflected against surfaces and doesn't rely on straight-line visual detection, it can pick up signals of enemy movements and deployments without compromising the drones carrying the hardware. The vector system's planned artificial intelligence improvements will also allow it to distinguish between different types of artillery and mortar systems based on their acoustic signatures. This capability could provide intelligence value that goes far beyond simple position detection. By identifying the specific types of weapons being used, military planners could gain insights into enemy unit compositions, logistical capabilities, and operational intentions. A drone that can distinguish between standard artillery and advanced rocket systems, for example, provides much more actionable intelligence than one that can only report gunfire detected. Furthermore, the system is designed to automatically orient the drone's optical sensors toward detected gunfire, enabling immediate visual confirmation and detailed reconnaissance of identified targets. This autonomous response capability addresses another practical limitation that constrained earlier acoustic detection systems: the time lag between detection and response. With Zvuk and Skyfortress, acoustic detection could alert human operators to incoming threats, but those operators then had to manually direct defensive responses. The vector system aims to eliminate much of this delay by automatically guiding the drone to achieve a real-time visual link. One of the main ways that Ukraine could leverage this is to become even more effective against Russian artillery systems, as that's the area where Russia has had a significant numerical advantage since day one. Traditional counter-battery operations require complex coordination between radar systems, communications networks, and artillery units to detect enemy fire and respond quickly enough to engage mobile targets before they can relocate. The new vector drones could potentially compress this entire cycle. A single drone could detect enemy artillery through acoustic sensors, visually confirm the target through its optical systems, and immediately transmit precise coordinates to friendly artillery or air assets for rapid engagement. And there's yet another aspect of using drones that surpasses what Skyfortress could ever hope to achieve – mobility. Vector-equipped drones can provide acoustic detection anywhere they can fly, including deep reconnaissance missions into enemy territory. On the other hand, land-based station systems are pretty much limited to working for defense. This could feasibly transform acoustic detection from a primarily defensive technology into an active intelligence-gathering tool that supports offensive operations. Of course, the drones aren't without their faults. They still have very limited detection ranges compared to radar systems. Additionally, the drone itself is reconnaissance only, having no offensive armaments by itself, or ways to work in hostile weather conditions with a lot of background noise. Furthermore, as the drone still needs a network link, Russia's counter-drone tactics might become developed enough to threaten them. Quantum Systems is expecting to start improving the drones and deploying them in the summer of 2025. This is just 3 years after the initial Zvuk experiments began. It's a remarkably compressed development cycle that would have been nearly impossible under peacetime military procurement processes. However, the vector system also reveals the ongoing limitations that constrain acoustic detection technology. The 15-kilometer detection range, while impressive for such miniaturized hardware, still represents a fraction of the coverage provided by modern radar systems. The acoustic sensors also remain vulnerable to the same environmental factors – weather conditions, background noise, and deliberate countermeasures – that affected earlier generations. And while the drones are technically only prototypes with limited battlefield testing results, the enthusiastic response from NATO is what matters. What NATO planners are studying is not just what Ukraine has accomplished, but how they accomplished it so quickly and cost-effectively. General Hecker's comments about being mighty impressed, and NATO Assistant Secretary General Tom Goffus calling the development crazy, reflect more than admiration for Ukrainian ingenuity. It shows that the US and the rest of Europe, with practically limitless resources compared to a war-struck Ukraine, somewhat stumbled in creating or adapting their military systems to follow the rapid leaps in technology throughout the 21st century. The cost implications alone represent a significant change in how NATO might start to plan its defensive systems and national militaries. Traditional air defense systems require enormous investments in sophisticated radars, missile systems, and command infrastructure. Ukraine's acoustic detection uses lower-cost technologies that can still provide results good enough to stymie one of the world's largest and most developed militaries outside of the NATO alliance. However, the strategic value extends beyond cost considerations. The progression from Zvuk through vector integration illustrates how technologies can evolve rapidly when driven by immediate needs rather than lengthy procurement processes. NATO's acquisition timelines range from 5 to 10 years for many critical systems. The war in Ukraine has lasted for a bit over 3 years and 4 months, and the acoustic system is on its third major iteration. How long would it have taken NATO to develop the same capability without a war taking place? And how much would it cost its nation's taxpayers? We'll leave the answers to those questions for you to ponder. The networking and data fusion capabilities demonstrated in Ukraine's systems also suggest how NATO could enhance its own integrated air defense systems. The ability to combine acoustic detection with radar, optical, and signal intelligence could improve detection reliability and reduce the vulnerability of traditional sensor systems to electronic warfare. Considering that NATO likely has significantly more powerful detection capabilities than Ukraine, it could mean a much more robust defensive system to provide an effective deterrent. Perhaps most significantly, the vector integration represents a new model for multi-domain sensor platforms that could lead to NATO overhauling its approach to surveillance and reconnaissance. The concept of mounting multiple sensor types on common platforms – optical, infrared, acoustic, and potentially others – could provide more comprehensive battlefield awareness than traditional single-sensor systems. While NATO hasn't made any claims of when it will work on adapting Ukraine's technology to its own use, it did establish the Joint Analysis Training and Education Center, or JTEC, in Poland, jointly operated with Ukraine. JTEC's involvement in researching acoustic detection possibilities indicates that both Ukraine and NATO firmly believe that this system has practical potential in modern warfare that is yet untapped. However, no system developed by Ukraine comes without its downsides. Environmental factors, range limitations, and vulnerability to countermeasures mean that acoustic systems could end up always playing second fiddle to traditional radar-based systems. It's also possible that the system hits an operational ceiling before it becomes practically usable, especially if Russia or China creates dependable counter-strategies. Of course, the system does come with one way to overcome some of these barriers through redundancy. While the three different systems are technically part of a linear progression of increasing mobility and reliability, each comes with its own use cases and operational advantages. As such, all three systems could be combined to provide broader coverage. The development from centralized to distributed to fully mobile detection systems wouldn't be possible without combining a few different concepts and emerging technologies, with each having major implications for the future of warfare itself. First, Ukraine managed to develop these systems not through widespread government programs, but through private small teams or companies. It indicates that small teams with focused objectives can outpace large, well-funded traditional development programs under the right circumstances. This could lead to serious questions within NATO about whether traditional defense procurement models are adequate for the rapidly evolving threat environment. Secondly, artificial intelligence advancement is also a major talking point for future systems, not only for acoustic detection. AI-enhanced drones have shown up multiple times in news reports, suggesting that artificial intelligence might replace some of the need for human operators. This could lead to widespread changes in how national militaries structure their training programs or fund specific units. If AI takes the lead in reconnaissance and surveillance, it will further decrease the manpower needs of each country. Considering that most of the Western world has had consistent difficulties in hitting their enrollment quotas, AI could help bridge that gap. Thirdly, miniaturization trends suggest that systems will continue becoming smaller, lighter, and more power efficient. This could enable integration into even smaller drone platforms or deployment of acoustic sensors on individual soldier equipment for personal area awareness. And this isn't really limited to acoustic detection. Ukraine has already managed to achieve significant results with small commercial drones for offensive missions. Shedding even a bit of weight on these lightweight systems could lead to exponential improvements in operational times. Going in another direction, a small drone that incorporates additional systems could become significantly more difficult to detect or counter through traditional means, giving it much more potential in covert operations. However, Ukraine is far from the only country to have encountered prodigious development leaps. If the technology proves as effective as current results suggest, other nations will likely develop their own acoustic detection capabilities, potentially changing the balance in various regional conflicts. Russia's reported development of acoustic detection systems that directly copy Ukrainian designs suggests that Russia and China are likely only slightly behind. As such, it would only take a small breakthrough for Ukraine to need to create counter-systems to technologies that it's barely perfected. For NATO, the main challenge will be integrating lessons learned from Ukrainian acoustic detection development with existing defense capabilities and procurement processes. The alliance must find ways to capture the innovation benefits of Ukraine's rapid developmental cycles while maintaining the quality standards and interoperability requirements necessary for the alliance's diverging operational needs. If you'd like this video, you might enjoy our analysis of how Ukraine has managed to stay ahead in the drone game. And as always, thank you for watching, and make sure to subscribe to our channel for daily news straight from reliable sources.